teaching first year physics here has given me a much greater appreciation for how amazing certain things are that go on in the real world. And they can be everyday things, literally like riding a bicycle, and actually being able to think about them, ask questions about them. The puzzles that we meet on everyday life, those are the things that lecturing this course in particular has given me better insight into. Because until you actually start teaching a subject, it's only then that you really start to understand it and understand all the nuances of it. I'm Lisa Jardine-Wright. I'm the Educational Outreach Officer at the Cavendish Laboratory here in Cambridge, and the Cavendish Laboratory is our Department of Physics. My PhD's in astrophysics, so I did galaxy formation simulations from the Big Bang to the present day for my PhD and for my postdoctoral research. And that was at the Institute of Astronomy here in Cambridge. Now I'm a Director of Studies at Churchill College. I'm a tutor there, and I lecture special relativity and rotational mechanics for first years doing the natural sciences course. We have students from all over the world, all walks of life, all different interests. So because of the Natural Science Tripos here, there are students that are learning physics, chemistry and biology all at the same time. So they may not be wanting to specialise in physics. So when you're lecturing, you have a huge wealth of diversity. I think the other thing I would say is that they're the thoughtfulness, right? Those students that really have a passion for the subject really listen in the lecture. They really come and they think and they ask you really insightful questions at the end. And for me as a lecturer, that's one of the challenges, but also one of the benefits as well. So in this equation, it's always that this centre of mass is referring to the body that you're interested in. So it's only when you're moving the axis with respect to the centre of mass of that body, not this one that is a combination of all of the others. Is that all right?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, good. So one thing that's interesting about teaching this course is in natural sciences in the first year, in physics we have 400 students. So it's quite a different environment from their environment at school. So we try to be interactive. I have something to show you for our breather today, but before we do that, I want to do a demonstration to see whether you have, through looking through that example, gathered some intuition about what's going on. So I have three objects here. They are all the same mass, and they are all the same radius. I have a solid sphere, a solid cylinder, not quite, but it's pretty much a good approximation to a solid cylinder, and a hollow cylinder. I'm going to start them at the same point on the ramp, and I want you to predict, I'm going to ask for a show of hands, which is going to reach the bottom first. Who thinks the solid sphere? And quite a few of you are sitting on the fence. That's fine. Okay. Right. So I'm going to do this twice because it's not easy to release them at the same time. 3, 2, 1. Okay. So the sphere was the clear winner, I think. I'm going to swap it around. Hollow, solid, sphere. That was bound to happen. So the hollow cylinder was last, the solid cylinder was second, and the sphere was first. So I will leave you again as an exercise between now and next time to think about why that happened.
But the most important thing for me, I think, is that they are willing to make mistakes. So I positively encourage them that solving problems, it's not about the answer, it's about the journey that they take along the way. And it's about learning through making mistakes rather than trying to get everything right all the time. And that again is quite a contrast from coming from school. Here, learning is about making mistakes and learning from those mistakes.
Dear world, yours, Cambridge.